What kind of people could do things like this?
Name's Jess. Jess Black. Find me at the lumber mill. The Kook's days are fucking numbered.
Worse than some of the shit I seen in that one camp.
Nice to take a breather. Well, still breathing.
Manipulated nature for ages, but they've done it all wrong. They've made us soft. They've made us complacent. They've made us sick. But when the farmer breeds his animals, he segregates them according to their traits. He discards the diseased and the inferior and the weak. He acts without conscience or empathy. We are the
Thank you.
guys.
Going as fast as my stomach can carry me. need your help. It's important. Thanks for busting me out. Name's Jess. If you're out here picking fights with the cult, then I'm guessing you already know my Uncle Dutch. Look, I don't got a lot of... Where the hell'd you come from?
I'll do mine. I wonder if we could have used our words to avoid fighting. Ah, hell no. Hurt, did you see?
Trail's gotta go cold. You sure as hell know how to handle yourself. All right, so thanks for busting me out. Name's Jess. If you're out here picking fights with the cult, then I'm guessing you already know my Uncle Dutch. Look, I don't got a lot of time to waste. I'm gonna get right to the point. I was on the trail of one of Jacob's zealots. Goes by the name The Cook. Yeah, don't sound so scary. But believe me, he's one twisted fuck. Almost tracked him down, but a Peggy patrol got the drop on me. I need your help. We can't let this trail go cold. This guy's butchered a lot of innocent folk around here. Can't let him get away with it any longer. Gotta move. Wasted too much time already. Follow me.
That could have been worse.
This way.
Hurt, did you say you...
See that? That's his calling card. Innocent people burned alive. Goddamn cults grabbing everyone. They'll take you from your home, the bar, even church. Don't matter where you are. Then they slot you into one of two categories. Weak or strong. See, Jacob's building an army. And anyone who can't or won't fight for it winds up dead. Culling the herd, he calls it. Wholesale slaughter innocent people. Nobody believed it was happening because nobody wanted to believe. Gotta breathe quieter, Herc. Give yourself away.
I'm gonna move from point B to point A, but probably not in that order.
The one we're after. The cook.
Got something.
He's one of Jacob's favorites. The one who leads his purge. The cook's bought into all of Jacob's bullshit. This motherfucker's gonna get what he deserves. Anywhere. Got some people.
was close.
What a bunch of assholes.
Please help.
What's up, Grace?
I owe you for that.
Hey!
The cook. He took others.
He'll let us go.
Took him up the mountain.
Could cheer you.
Thanks, Deputy. I thought I was a dead man.
But there were others. They took them up the mountain.
What's happening?
Okay, let's get moving.
To his bunker. Gotta be a Whitetail militia or someone he really...
You wanna know why they call him the cook? A couple years back, Jacob sent one of his guys out to round up this family. Parents and kids. First thing he did was starve them. Gave them nothing. Not even a drop of water. After 3 days, they got so thirsty they had to drink their own piss. Like the kids didn't want to do it. So the parents forced it down their throats. The kids puked it right back up. Cook didn't like that. So he went and strung the parents up on posts under the hot sun.
Hey there, ma'am.
Hey, sir.
Hold up. I think I heard something.
Hey, sir.
How do you do, man?
Let's look at what's going on.
I got to get over there.
You're gonna execute him. Take point. Got the back. Remember. If they spot us, those people are dead on sight.
Hey, we got a bad guy.
I can't stay put here, amigo.
Doomed either way.
Things were reversed.
Don't give up.
Gonna get a better view.
You don't help me. I'm dead.
Thank you.
Please help me. My husband. The cook took him to the pit. He's gonna burn him.
Yo.
He's gonna burn him alive.
Let's go.
Well, I don't think they liked us very much.
I've always heard about the wolf stand. Just never thought I'd see it.
So the cook. He had the parents on posts. Decided to give the kids a little water. And then he asked if they were hungry. The kids were starving, so they said yes. Started begging for food. The cook asked if they want pork. The kids said yes. So he went out to the parents and took their shoes off and started to play. This little piggy went to market. And the blood poured like a damn faucet. Cook had a big old grin on his face as he offered each little piece to the kids.
Hey, Miss Armstrong, did you really win an Olympic medal?
Yeah.
I'll never forget that smell. When they finally stopped screaming, I looked around. He was just gone. Vanished like some sort of demon in the night. Anyways, that's why they called him the Cook. Jacob's been training up his troops, but whatever. I'm still gonna kill every last one of them bastards. Let's take a better look.
The weak are impure and unworthy!
There he is.
Their souls are plagued by filth!
We got company!
So he cooks them with the flame! Burn! Burn with the light of our Father! Sacrifice the weak! The weak are impure and unworthy! Cleanse your soul with God's righteous flame!
I'm gonna move from point B to point A, but probably not in that order.
That was right.
How goes it, ma'am?
Cook's dead, and I don't feel anything. All I ever wanted was to find this guy. And now, I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Dutch has been right about a lot of shit lately. Colt, Eli, maybe he's right about you, too. You need someone to watch your back? Call me. And, thanks for everything you've done.
Grace, you were in the Middle East. This shit is harder. What up, Grace? You were in the Middle fucking East. But I bet this shit is harder.
You know it.
Yeah, Deputy. If it were up to me, you would have been dead a long time ago. Joseph has other ideas, and he wants to talk to you, so that's what you're gonna do. Don't worry, my hunters will bring you to him.
Ah, shit! He's coming for you again, kid! You better be careful! Those hunters could be anywhere!
Get my move on. I'm a bust a move, except the dance in, it's escaping.
Moving now!
Good, okay. I think I found someone.
one of you will be strong.
Well, again.
Yeah, your peaches.
I know you're in pain. The Lord giveth and the Lord taketh, huh? You're not the only one to be tested. Did you know that I had a wife? So beautiful, isn't she? We were pregnant with our first child. And we were just babies ourselves, really. And I was terrified of becoming a father, mostly about money. She wasn't worried. She had faith that things were gonna work out. She always had faith. And one day she was gonna go visit a friend. There was an accident. The Lord take her. They rushed me to a hospital and put me in a room with this little pink bundle stuffed with tubes. And they said that I had to be strong, because my little girl was going to live. God was looking out for our daughter. And they left me alone in the room with her. I just stared at my daughter. So helpless, so innocent. And all she had in the world was me. When nobody from nowhere with puppy. And in that moment, I knew that God was testing me. He was laying out a path before me, and all I had to do was choose. So I put my hand on my little girl's head, and I leaned in and I could smell. Prayed together, prayed for wisdom, prayed for strength, and I knew, I heard God's plan for me. And I took my fingers and I put them on that little plastic tube that was taped, her angelic face, and I pinched it shut. Began to kick and kick. And then nothing. Stillness. Release. The Lord giveth and the Lord taketh. Pain. Sacrifice. These are all part of His test. And we have to prove that we can serve God. No matter what he asks. You've done well.
Thank you.
Watch your time. Time ticking.
You're no hero!
Good. Good. Call the herd.
Kill! Kill! Kill!
Tick-tock. Do it again. Sacrifice the weak.
Make your sacrifice!
That's it. Watch your time.
Petey? It's Eli. Just checking in. Nobody's seen you in a while. Whitetails could really use your help out there. Pop by the wolf stand if you get the chance. We got a lot of work to do.
Anybody who's wearing orange scrubs are pledged.
The hell?
Now we know where some armless people end up.
Hopefully for good.
Yeah.